Learning modules are great for displaying content sequentially. To begin, roll over Build Content, and under the Create category, select Learning Module. Provide a title, and select a special color for that title, if you desire. As is common in Blackboard Learn, you can add a description using the What You See Is What You Get text editor. But before you click Submit, there are a couple options for learning modules that are unlike those given for other content in Learn. First, you can choose to enforce sequential viewing of the learning module, which means that each page of the learning module must be visited before the following page can be viewed. And by default, the learning module will display a table of contents on the left side, but you may disable this, which will restrict your students' navigation to moving forward or backward one page at a time. You can also select the display format for any hierarchies you create within the learning module. Click Submit. Now I'm switching edit mode off to show you some examples as students would see them, and I will collapse the side menu. If both sequential viewing and the table of contents are enabled, only the current item and the item up next in the sequence will appear as links, as you see here. But once I click on item number 2, item number 3 is immediately underlined and becomes active as a link, while item number 4 remains inactive. If sequential viewing is not enforced, and a table of contents is available, all links in the table of contents will be active. One word of warning, if you choose to add an interactive tool, such as a discussion board, blog, or journal, inside a learning module, it will launch in a new window and without the table of contents or the page navigation in the upper right-hand corner. This may confuse your students, especially if you have other pages in the learning module that should follow the interactive tool. Here we see the discussion board window that popped up when I clicked on the link from the table of contents. But you'll notice that even if I restore this menu on the left, the learning module's table of contents is not present until I close this window and return to the original learning module. And lastly, if you do not display the table of contents, the student's sole source of navigation will be the arrow icons and page indicators in the upper right. And now you know how to create and configure a learning module in Blackboard Learn.